Hi, a very good morning. This is Abhay from Anupatra Information Solutions. Thank you for joining me for the day three, final day for the series we are doing for students. Thank you for the feedback that you have been giving us on our sessions. A huge credit goes to you guys who have been using this time to learn a new skill. It's been difficult for all of us. I hope you are at home, safe with your family at this difficult time. Let's start with a brief introduction to my company. Manupatra Information Solutions started its journey in the year 2000 as the pioneers of the online legal search in India. Since then, we have grown into the largest content aggregator for Indian and international database, linking both primary and secondary data. So over 20 years, what has really helped us, apart from the 20 years loyal clientele, is our continued dedication towards technology. So we see ourselves as a technology company in a publishing industry. So a lot of, in the back end, a lot of technology goes into like artificial intelligence, natural language processing, visualization tools. So a lot of thought that goes into is how to make it simpler, how to make it easier, how to make it faster for our users to be able to get to the most relevant document in least possible time. Okay, so this is our more focus. Let's start with the demo. Either you will be able to access by username password, just enter username here, password, or if your college has an IP subscription, so whenever you're connected to your college Wi-Fi, this will be an option. There will be an option available here, IP user, click here. So from that you will be able to access. Okay, so this is my home screen. We have had two sessions before this. So in the first session, we dive deep into the table of content. So we discussed everything that is there in the table of content. In yesterday's session, we discussed Manu search, legal search, citation search, assisted search. So every button in these searches was clicked. Now today we'll be discussing the features that were left, but since many of you will be joining us for the first time, so we've kept that in mind, and we'll be showing a lot of case studies that will just revise all the features, and we'll take a lot of question and answers. So yesterday's session, there were so many question answers. So we have decided that, you know, to sort, to book a more time for that. Okay, so let's start with legal analytics. So this is there. This is just beneath Manu search. I don't know how many of you would have clicked this. Okay, so once you click this one, it gives me three options: search analytics, judge analytics, advanced judge analytics. Search analytics is, it's a visualization tool. So I'll just write my topic, gender justice. Now what it gives me is a graphical representation of all the relevant cases related to gender justice. So many of us are visual thinkers. You know, we need to see pictures to make ourselves understand a particular concept. So this is giving you a visual picture, and it is also giving you the relationship between all these cases. Okay. So many a times we go to different clients and they ask us, you know, what is the most landmark judgment on this topic? So it's a way to answer that question. So all the landmark judgments are available in front of you, and they're different sizes. So size here matters. So, you know, this particular case, if I take my finger here, so this is Daya Ram versus Sudhir Batam. This came in 2011. If I click onto this case, it has been cited 90 times. Okay, 90 plus times. Of that, it has been discussed in subsequent cases. So wherever any future court has discussed this 55% times. Similarly, this has been mentioned 34% times. It has been relied on 11% times. So you get all this data regarding all these. So let me quickly start from the below. So this is this timeline. So over the years from here, you will be able to see that on your particular topic, judgments have been slowly rising. This is a good news for gender justice. These are all the high court judgments. Okay, so this is a Jharkhand High Court judgment. This is Supreme. This is Gujarat High Court judgment. Okay, so different Heiko judgments are in this y-axis. When we go up, these are all the Supreme Court judgments. Now here you will see that the size of the balloon is much bigger than the High Court ones, because the Supreme Court case tends to be cited more. Okay. So once I take my finger there, it will give me the name of the case. Once I click onto this one, this will give me a brief synopsis of the editorial inputs that we are providing. So this is done by our editorial team. So they put in the keywords, they put in the future citing reference. So what happened to this case after 2000, so how many times it was discussed, how many times it was mentioned. So just to give you a brief idea, the more a case was relied on or affirmed, positive treatment is there, that's more suitable. The more a case is dissented, that's not a very good sign. Okay, so this is acts also, so all the acts that were used. So similarly, in other features, you will be able to see case note also related to this feature. Okay, now one thing else that it gives me is information about how many times it has been cross-referenced. So this particular case, Charu Khanna versus Union of India, has been used in these many cases. Okay, in the various high courts cases, in the various Supreme Court. So this also gives me an idea on the significance of this case, of how many times people are citing it. Similarly, this case has been used in these two judgments. Okay, so I found this case helpful. So I can just click on anyone. I can just go to results page. Click on gender justice. Okay, from here, say I can go to this one. From results page, I'll be able to see whichever judgment is there. So all the 40 judgments, hyperlink is also given to me from here. Okay. So all these judgments, if you want to open, you can open. So say, this is Mukesh Kumar judgment. This looks good. Big. Let's open this one. Okay. So in many search engines, your search is over once you get to a case. You know, that's the end of the search. You take out the printout, you go to the court. In Manu Patra, what happens is, there's so many things that we are just included in the case law only. So anytime we show the demo, we make sure that we show the entire template of the judgment, because there's so many cases that have been referred, which have been relied on. So all that information you'll get. So even one case, if you're able to get in Manu Patra, you'll at least be able to extract 3-4 cases from that case. Okay, so this is similarly, so everything is simple feature, everything is hyperlinked. So it's a Supreme Court judgment, this has been hyperlinked to that particular court. Similarly, any section is also there, that is also hyperlinked. If any notification is there, that is also hyperlinked. So jumping from one page to another, it's very, very easy here. So Indian Penal Code, I just click onto that one. Similarly, if there is commentary also, so you can read the commentary also from here. Copy paste is very simple. Just use your buttons, Control C plus Control V, and you'll be able to do that. Is another very small but very useful feature for students. Double click on any word, and you will be able to see the dictionary meaning of that word. So inflicted, punishment inflicted. Similarly, this goes for Latin phrases also. Just select the particular phrase and you'll be able to get the judgment on that one. Meaning on that one. Okay, so this is the bottom of the judgment. If you want to go to the top, these are all the buttons. So sometimes you just open a judgment and you just want to go to the last. So you can always use these navigation tools to go to the up. This is how it's look on the top. So this is Manu citation. We have different citations. We have like more than 325 journals. So all the major journals are there. DLT, AIR, SEC, Scale. So citations from all these journals you will be able to access in volume 1 till today. These are some of the very, very important features that are there in all the judgments. Come to that in a minute. This is the date of the judgment. This is all the honorable judges are. And there, this is also is another feature. This is judge analytics. We'll come to that. Okay. This is Council query consoles names are also hyperlinked. So once I click on anyone, you'll see, you can see where particular lawyer has appeared recently. A relevant section, so subject is also there. So any judgment that comes in Manupatra is given a particular subject. Criminal one, constitution is one, intellectual property right is one. So you can directly go to the criminal cases. If you want, there is search for that. Relevant section. So this is again done by our editorial team. This is, these many cases acts were used in this particular case, but actually this case was based on just a handful of 10 sections. So we have segregated these from these. Okay, so relevant section is, there's a separate search for relevant section that is also available. Just if you want to exact precise section, you want case on that. So you will be able to do that. Again, cases referred. So list of all the cases that has been referred in this case. So here. So any citation in Manu, there will be this small wheel that will be there. So you can click on to this one. And again, it gives me the treatment in future cases. So sometimes I'm reading a judgment. All I have is the party name, you know, just the citation. I don't know anything about that case. So once you click on to this wheel, you will be able to get more information. You know, this has been cited more times. This has been mentioned these many times. So you can just gaze the relevance of that judgment, you can click on to this button. Okay, so any cases referred, prior history. So this case came from Delhi High Court. So that is also linked to this one. If this was challenged by some other case, so that is also referred. So everything is given to you in a one flow. You need not go to some other place and, you know, find out. So every information that you might need is provided to you from here. Similarly, citing references. So backward linking, we call it. Backward linking is, which are the cases of all those cases, how many were relied, how many were affirmed, how many were discussed, and how many were mentioned. So we have segregated them in terms of treatment. Suppose I found this case very relevant. I want to read this judgment which relied on this. So there's another judgment I can just quickly go and read. So similarly, if you find a case, you know, you want, this is the case, but it's arguing something opposite to what I want. So you can always find the dissented tab also here. So you'll be able to find cases that dissent with that case. So everything is available to give you like most relevant judgment that you might need to look. Case note is there. So case note, facts, the case note on this one. What was held? Deepak Mishra, sir. This is concurring view is also given. Everything is put in place in the case note itself. So if you just quickly the case note, that you will be able to do. So entire this, we have a 200 people team that sits just for the, you know, putting the link, putting the hyperlinks, putting all these data, collecting that every day for you guys. Nobody else is doing this kind of tool. Nobody is thinking. Mostly people are concerned with, you know, just providing printout that you can take out to the court. But how to take the legal search a step forward? Okay, so now let's come to these features. So similarly, if there is a commentary on this case, so you can always read a commentary. PM Bakshi, sir, commentary is there on this one. Now, this is important para. This is M button. Let's click on, let me click on this one. Now, what does M para does? M para gives me the key paragraph of a judgment. So, it is there for this paragraph. We are saying 334th paragraph of the judgment is the key paragraph. Now, how do we say that? Because this has been quoted verbatim in some other judgment. So this is Srishant versus Court Council of India. Okay, this is the Srishant cricketer. So this has been used verbatim in the future cases. So this has been quoted one time. Okay. Similarly, there is another paragraph from this judgment has been quoted one time. This will give me another paragraph in our country. So it gives me the list of paragraphs which are quoted in this particular judgment. So, you know,
sometimes you are going through, this is a big judgment and you don't want to read everything. You can just come here, read the important paras, which are the paragraphs which are quoted, which are being quoted in other judgments. Just read three paragraphs. If you find this is the thing that you're looking for, then you can always read the next judgment. Okay, so this is also another 2018 judgment. We just quoted this. So this probably is the same that you're looking for. There are two judgments you have been able to get from this button. Another one is cited in para. What does cited in para does? It gives me where this judgment has been quoted in other judgments. This has been cited 155 times. So 155 times after 2017, people have used this case. Now, where, in which judgments? Now, these are the list of judgments. Recently, a Madhya Pradesh High Court judgment on 3rd March used this in these two paragraphs. Okay. So now here we are taking it a step further. Okay. So you are getting the list of the judgments. You are also getting the paragraph of the judgment. Now, how is this helpful for me? You know, I read this paragraph from Uttaranchal High Court and I see this is very helpful to me. Now I can read it. Okay, now you don't have to go to that judgment and find that paragraph where it was mentioned. So to save all that hassle, everything is available, just that paragraph. If you think this is helpful to me, you can always click here. So comprehensively cross-referenced. Okay, let me come to the next one. So this is authority timeline. I'll come to it after case map. Now case map again. There's a lot of visualization that goes in Manupatra. This is Mukesh Kumar. It gives you, case map basically gives you 20 relevant judgments for a particular case. So this is Mukesh Kumar. Now Mukesh Kumar, take this as a timeline. This is a 2017 case. Now all these on the left hand side are the cases that have come before 1996. And they have been cited in Mukesh Kumar. So there might be a case which was affirmed in Mukesh Kumar. This was discussed. This was relied on. So these 10 cases were cited in Mukesh Kumar, and there were different treatments that was given by Mukesh Kumar to these cases. So this is backward linking. Okay. Now I want to see the forward looking after 2017. What happened to this case? There were many cases which similarly discussed. Ashishant also discuss this case, the one case which affirmed this. So you'll get a brief bird eye view, all the 20 most relevant cases where this has been cited, where this is being affirmed. So similarly, if it was overruled or like dissented by another case, that also you'll be able to see from here. Okay, now this doesn't stop here. So once you click on, say, any other, say, I'll click on this one. So now this will be the center. So now this is the center of my solar system. From this, I can see where this case has been discussed further, where this was affirmed further. So, you know, this was not possible 20 years before. Even the best of the senior advocates won't have this kind of technology 20 years before, because you can see where a case was affirmed, where that was affirmed. So everything is available to you from here, the entire relationship. Okay, let's come to this one. This was case map. Let's click on this one. This is authority timeline. Okay, so authority timeline is the same as case map, but it gives me the treatment of all. There we were just showing the 20 cases. Here you will see all the cases. So this is the list of all the cases where this was affirmed, discussed. Similarly, the size of the balloon again matters here. So the more a case is cited in this particular case, that the higher will be the radius of that case. Okay. Similarly, I can segregate them in terms of distinguished. Okay. One case, it has been distinguished. It's a Allahabad High Court judgment. If it was dissented somewhere, no case where it was dissented. If it was relied on some case, so this is one case where it was relied on, Bombay High Court. This particular case has been cited one time. All this information you will be able to gather from these visualization tools available. So I'd request, anytime you open Manupatra next time, just open any of your favorite judgment, and you will be able to just click on these buttons one time and everything will be clear. Okay, so this is the common words that are occurring. So this is injured witness. Injured witness is coming in this judgment a lot. You can just see where injured witness is, but witness, okay.
Similarly, this is another feature. This is basically what the technology is called crowdsourcing. So basically, it gives me people who have seen this judgment in Manupatra. So we are using historical data, the search patterns that we have in Manupatra. Which is the next judgment that they tend to open after this? So this is Vishakha landmark judgment on gender justice. Krishna Das versus Henry Joseph. So again, this is something that you can look into if you don't know, you know, what else to do next. So this is what other people have been doing. PDF. So if you are looking for a PDF without case note, with case note, with Manupatra
brand name,
that will be there. This is a big judgment, let it load. Okay. If you want to send a mail to a colleague, to a friend, to anyone, subscriber, non-subscriber, no problems. My internet working fine. Around this time, 11:51. Okay. Okay, so let me show you this one first. This is the PDF format. The Manupatra branding is there. So you can easily able to bring it to court authority website. This is if you want to send that email, let it load. If you want a Word format for this, again, very, very helpful. This is one of our most used features because for drafting, it's very easy to just get the Word format and use it from there. This is a sticky note. This is used to create different, you can leave a research trail. So we have done a comprehensive session on all these. This is available on our YouTube channel. So just go to YouTube, search Manupatra, and you will be able to get to these sessions that we had. Again, if you want to save it in cloud, so Google Drive, Dropbox on your mail, if you want to save it. This is if you want to save it in our cloud. So, you know, you're just working on something in your office or in, you can always go back and save it in our cloud. And from wherever you will open Manupatra next, this will be available in this folder, My Saved Documents. Just go to My Saved Documents and you'll be able to get to that judgment. Okay. So these are some of the features that are available. You can just, next time you open a judgment, click on each one of these, no rocket science, everything will be able to figure out. Okay, so now come to this one. This is print replica. So print replica is the code copy basically of any judgment. So this is as it is appearing in judas.nic. So what we ensure is that you get the basic, you know, the source material for the judgment. So this is where many publishers I've started changing the paragraphs in the judgment also. That is creating a lot of problems. So we don't do that, but still, if you find any problem, you can always come here and see in the source if you find a problem. Okay, so this is just what a case looks like in Manupatra. Let's go back to our analytics page. So this was search analytics. Now, similar analytics is available for judges. You can see from here the judgment that they have written. Let's go to advanced analytics directly. So again, a visualization tool. So this is available for both Supreme Court and High Court judges. Just a small data that we have compiled for you. You can choose anyone. Say my favorite is Sikri sir. Okay, so this is from Sikri sir. This is period wise 2013-2019. The Supreme Court judge. Now, from here, you can see the year wise pronouncement. So, before retiring in 2019, he wrote 15 judgments. He authored 15 judgments. Part of the bench, 48 judgments. Okay. So, similarly, this is everything is hyperlinked. Click onto this one, you will be able to see which are those 15 judgments which he authored.
Now, coming to the subject wise, so if you're going in front of a say, Supreme Court or any new high court you're going, and you just want to see what, you know, his inclination towards a particular subject. So all these cases are available. You can just click on that particular subject and you'll be able to see judgments. This is counsels that have been appearing most in front of them. So here you can see V. Krishna Prasad sir has appeared 291 times. This is again very helpful to law firms. Next. So this data is available to in public domain. So this is available to everyone. We are the only one that is investing our manpower and our engineers to, you know, to work with this data. How can we use this? So to see a pattern in this sea of data that is available in the public domain. So this is disposition wise, which he tends to dismiss, which he tends to allow in favor of this. So sometimes people wait, it's holiday going, they tend to wait, you know, to favorable bench. So that you can see from here. This is decided. So you're going in front of a new judge, you know, you can just take the judgment that he prefers from a judge. So this is, he tends to, Mr. Sikri sir has cited Sinha sir 207 times in his judgments. So click on to this one, it will give you all those judgments where he cited Sinha sir. Now works both ways. So who is citing him? So Teji sir, our own Delhi High Court judge, retired recently. So he's been citing him 280 times. He has cited him. Both ways you will be able to. So you can do this for any of your favorite judge. Similarly, this is a citing reference in Supreme Court. This is a citing reference in High Court. So how many times he has been affirmed, discussed, dissented, all that is available. Okay. So this was analytics. This was available from this folder. So just beneath Manu search, you'll find this folder. Okay, we had covered everything in Manu Legal. Let's come to compare provisions. So compare provisions is you can compare the constitution of two countries. Okay, so this, if you just want to read one, you can download also, like for India, if you want to download the constitution USA, and there's a compare provision also available. So if you want to compare these two, say, let's take this, that controversial word these days, secular. So where secular is coming in Indian constitution and where is it coming in Afghanistan constitution? I could have chosen Pakistan also, but since Afghanistan, okay, so there's no secular here. We have, so for any word you can do, or you can just read constitutions of different countries. Okay, similarly, act wise comparison is also there. So if you're looking for say comparison of Delhi, this is something that corporates do a lot, you know, Shop and Establishment Act. So you want to compare Delhi with say Haryana, say Gurgaon. So I just write shop here and I can select Punjab. Okay, from here you will be able to see both these two acts. Similarly, there's sometimes a confusion regarding the stamp duty also with different state, that also you can do from here. Say I'll select one, say penalties, comparing apples to apples. compare. Okay. So from here you will be able to make out how different it is. Okay, this is 250 rupees, and here they are charging 300 rupees for a offense. Okay, so here you can compare the provisions. This is law as an inception, very very useful. Say I'll show you for something that is more recent. Consumer Protection Act. So Consumer Protection Act has been passed in 2019. Now sometimes we just remember the section. So I remember section 2 was this. Now what has changed? Now the sections are all different. You can see the compare provisions, what has changed over the period between these two, one's repealed act and the current act. So just If you have any doubt, you can come here and compare these two. The entire list is available here. Okay. So this was for the features that we had not covered yesterday. Now we have some case studies that I've planned for you, or I can just take some questions, like 2-3 questions, and we can then move to case studies. Okay. Let's start. Good morning. Let's start with yes, sir. Equivalent citation. Okay. I'll show you for any judgment. Say this video will be available in YouTube, so you can always go back and check for yourself. Okay. So the equivalent citation will be available, sir, here for any judgment. This is Manu citation. Click on to this one. It will give you the equivalent. So right on the top left, the citation is there. Okay, let's take the next one. Equivalent citation. This is a more specific query. We'll discuss it maybe after the end of the session. Okay. The distinguished cases where this was, where this, I am not a legal person, but there, where this was confirmed, like this was given a positive result. Distinguished case. Okay. The meaning of, so case note is basically the head note of the judgment, Gautam sir. So the head note of the judgment is there. Please repeat the last part of the judgment. Okay. Sumit sir, you have been a regular. I'll come to that. There are different case studies also that we have planned. Okay. Okay. Cases from section. So I'll there's a different search. There's a case study for that. And we'll discuss this in a case studies. Okay. So let's come to the case studies. Manu Patra webinar. Okay. So this is number one. So, what are the Supreme Court guidelines for candidates seeking to contest elections during nomination? So again, we use natural language processing. So let's do like just copy paste this to our Manu search, see what happens. Sometimes it gives results, sometimes to do something else, but most times you'll be able to find relevant results just by typing your query. Okay, so since we are looking for Supreme Court guidelines, it always makes sense. So this is how you can use the table of content also. So if you're looking for a Delhi High Court judgment, just go to Delhi and select. Now, since we are looking for Supreme Court guidelines, it always makes sense to select Supreme Court from here and then make my search. Okay, these are the 19 some results. So in a matter of half a second, it has gone through millions of judgments, and these are the 19 relevant results. Okay, so one thing that you can do is you can read the case note and head note from here, and you will be able to guess if it's relevant for you. So this is the head note, by the way. This is case note, just a brief synopsis of the judgment that can be accessed from here. Let me open this. So this is the full text of the judgment. So either I can just control F and use that to search where guideline is there. Otherwise, there's this important para. So important para, as I told you, it gives you the most quoted paragraph. This is one such para. I think this is it. So this is the guideline that has been given by Supreme Court for a candidate filing for nomination. So just to show you how easy it is, just write your keywords and open a judgment, read a case note, come to these features, and these will guide you automatically. So everything is in a flow. Okay, let's come to the next one. Okay, this is, I'm looking for recent judgments on IPR under the subject dealing with infringement. Okay, these are dealing with infringement. So as I was telling you, there are like 50 subject categories automatically available in Manu Patra. So there's one search, intellectual property right now. How did I get here? I went to legal search, and there is
a option available for subject. I can make my search from here. Okay, now it's only searching in Supreme Court. We can just for now, search in Supreme Court judgments, and I can search with infringement. I hope I get the spelling correct. Okay, just be fine. Okay, so these are 80 results on intellectual property right dealing with infringement. Okay, so very easily you can do it. Coming to the next one. Okay, so this is a more complicated query. I'll give you half a minute to read this. Okay, so visitation right of father to his children in case of non-payment of maintenance. Okay, just go to Manu search. Visitation right of father in case of non-payment. Okay, so what we can do in Manu search is we can break, ideally what we suggest is, sometimes you can write the entire query if you're not able to find the judgment, because sometimes what people do is they write 2-3 lines in Manu search. So that way the system gets confused and it doesn't know what you are actually searching for. So it always helps to focus on your keywords. So I can say, reading this, I can say, what are my keywords? Visiting right is one, payment of maintenance might be another. Okay. So visiting rights, since it's a case of visiting rights, it's always makes sense to search visiting rights. Okay, just make sure that all the judgments where visiting rights is coming, you can use that. Okay, now what I can also do is I can say ki this visiting rights, there's a concept of wildcards. So for those who are not with us yesterday, this might be new for you, but this is available in our YouTube video, so you can go back and refresh. Okay, so this is visiting rights. So visiting right can always be visitation rights, can be visits. So visit and rights that you can do from here. So I have put in a small star. I'll just zoom in so that you'll be able to see better. So I've put in a star after visit and I've put in a star after right. So it will take different forms of visit and different forms of star. Now I can also do a near each other here. Okay. Or I can just put it in inverted commas. So now once I do that, it will take all the judgments where visiting right or visitation rights are coming. Okay. Also select this near each other. So what near each other does is it searches for all those judgments where visit and write are coming in a range of 20 words. Okay. So a little technical. Let me explain it more. So it's looking for these two words, visit writes, in all the judgments where these two are coming in between a range of 20 words. Okay. I've done nothing. I've just put in my keyword here and I've selected near each other. So this is a radio button. So either you can do this or this. Okay. I've selected this near each other and I've searched. So now it is searching visit and rights in a proximity of 20 words. So all those judgments where rights and visit or visited or rights are coming, there are 9,000 some judgments. You will be able to see these. Now I can search in result. So search in result is basically my second query. So no maintenance paid. So from there what I did here is I just broke my query. So I, instead of writing everything at once, I segregated like two things and I refined in this one. Now it's searching for no maintenance paid in these 9,000 some judgments. Okay, so this is an advice that we give, that you can always start with a bigger one, and you can always go down to the smaller searches. Here you can see no maintenance was paid to her. These are all relevant results. Coming to the next search. So these are all available in different forms in YouTube also. Okay. Now visitation rate. Now this is another query. Somebody had asked how to do a section based query in Manupatra. So the answer is, like, if you even if you want to use two sections, that also you'll be able to do 178 and 138. So how to do a two section based query in Manupatra. So legal search is there. Manu search is for your keywords, basically. Legal search is if you have a particular section in mind, if you have a particular party name in mind, it's always suggested to use this legal search. So legal search, the format is already given to you. Yahan it's written type any three letters. So I'm looking for CRPC. I just write CRPC. So in the section button, it's looking for, yes, it was 176. 178, and this is negotiable instrument, so I can write NI and it will automatically pick up negotiable. I can just write 138. Okay, so I put in my two sections here, made my search. Okay, so it's giving me all the judgments of 178 and 138, they both were used. Okay, now anytime a new icon is there, you should be a little curious. So here is one. So we also give you the SLP status on any case. So this is a Calcutta High Court judgment 2018. So there was an SLP filed against this case and it has been disposed of. So SLP is basically somebody has filed a petition for against this case order in Supreme Court, but that has been disposed of. So sometimes it's not disposed. We have a separate icon for that. That is a red one. So that also you'll be able to see. So SLP status also you can check from here. Okay, this is for section wise. Okay. Now coming to the next one, this is my client has a shop in Karol Bagh, which has been forcibly taken by his tenant. He wants to file a case for the tenant to be evicted from property. Okay. Now, there is another search. There is assisted search. How different is Manu search from assisted search? Assisted search, basically, it's written here, Boolean search made easy. Okay. So here you don't, if you don't want to use inverted commas. Okay. So here we have provided with you with a simple form that you can just fill. This is self-explanatory both. Say that was a Delhi Karol Bagh case. So I can always write Delhi rent control. Okay. So this Delhi rent control will be there in the particular thing, in the judgment. So all the judgments where Delhi rent control is there. Let me make a search on that one. Okay. So these are 6,000 some judgments where Delhi rent control is there. Now I'm refining this. I'm saying, say, tenant eviction. Cases based on tenant eviction. So I can just give a proximity. I want 10 words where tenant and eviction is coming, and I can give a range here. Okay, now the results have come down to 3,007. Now I can either write shop or I can either write, say, commercial establishment. So both can work depending on, so there's no just one way or one way to search this, but you can use different keywords, whatever is coming to your mind at that point in time, you'll be able to get these judgments. So all these, there's 9 judgments. You click one on any one of them, say this one is there. Read this one. Okay, on eviction, it's there, the rent control. This might have been cited in another case. You can always go on to that case. These are the two judgments where this was cited. So again, you will get many cases just from reading one case.
always read the case note also. Okay. Let's come to the next one. Okay, so let's go to this one. So how do we, during your internship, you are reporting to a senior. He has asked you to email him the Supreme Court decision in which Vodafone case is being mentioned. So Vodafone case basically has given you the party name of that case. And he's given you, it has also a Bombay High Court appeal. Okay. So I just have a party name. It's always suggested to use legal search to look for party name. So say I write Vodafone and I select Supreme Court from here. Okay. So this is all the cases where Vodafone is a party in Supreme Court. Sorry. So these are orders also, judgments also. So when you search from legal search in appellate respondent, it will only search in the title of the judgment. Okay. So sometimes people go to Manu search and write Vodafone. So there Vodafone might have been mentioned in a very landmark case. So that times it's appearing more. So it's always suggested if you're looking for a party name, go to legal search appellant respondent. Now, six of these are the judgments. 96 are just orders. Select the judgments. Okay. So now we can see which is the more landmark. So this has been cited 6 times. This has been cited 3. This has been cited more number of times. This might be a judgment. Just open this from here. Okay. I've made search on some legal counsel's name. Okay. So this is our judgment. If you want to take out a printout, you can do it. If you directly want to send a mail, you know, you don't want to download this, there is an option available. From here, it will go as the attachment in that particular judgment. Let it load. It might be a big judgment. Sometimes that weighs. That's why it takes time. Okay. So another question of this, similarly, acts are there, relevant sections are there, cases overruled. So prior history is also there. So this is, he was also asking for the Bombay High Court appeal, I guess. So that is also mentioned in this one. Just click on here and you will be directed to the Bombay High Court decision. These salvages are represented. Vodafone in this case. Okay. So, okay. Now here, from here, you will be able to send the mail. Just send to, and just type a message if you want, and it's just enter send. Automatically, it will go. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Okay. How do we find stamp fee for Delhi in Stamp Duty Act? Okay. So the premise for this question is that how do you do an act search? Okay. So that is possible from legal search. Go to act search. So in legal, there is a different windows available. Just go to stamp at the act search. Just write first three letters, say stamp, and I Indian Stamp Act. And from here, if I want to see this, I can select this one. You selected act, the entire act will open. But here the query is more specific. We are looking for Delhi schedule. So just write search Delhi here. And wherever in the Stamp Duty Act, yesterday also there was a question, how do we find out in the main act, different state? From there, you can always search Delhi. Okay, so this is the schedule. If you want to take out a printout of this, that also you can do. You can send a mail also. Okay. Let's come to the next one. How do you do a citation search in Manupatra? Okay. Let's come to the citation search. So again, citation search is available here. So as I said earlier, we have more than 325 citations that are available. So all these journals from Inception, Taxman, SEC, DLT, AIR. So all these journals from volume one will be able to access here. Select Okay, select Indian citation, select the publisher. Say I'm looking for CTR, like the journal. Just, you don't have to do much. Everything is there in the table. Just fill this form. Say I want to search for the year 1985. Select the volume number, 47. Select page number, 126. Again, and make a search. Okay, so this is my judgment. Double taxation, 1985. From here, you will be able to get to the judgment just by using the citation. So you're reading an article, there's a citation that comes. So sometimes you just have the citation. So you will be able to make that search. Along with that, you will be able to make that search partially. So even if you don't have the complete citation, you can just, if you don't have 4126, you can just search the entire volume. So 65 results are there. You can just read the party name, whichever is suitable to you. You'll be able to find that case. Let's come to the next one. Insolvency advocate. What are the primary? Okay, so we have a special folder available in business policy where you will be able to get that. So we are looking for insolvency table of contents. So in business policy, on a particular subject of law, all the primary and secondary database is there. So primary acts, bills, rules, regulations, notifications. Secondary is what are the forms, cases relevant to a particular section, guidelines, reports. So these are also available. If you just want to update yourself on these things, you can always come here in business policy and you'll be able to do that. Okay, so let's hold it for the with the case studies. We can focus on the queries that you have. Okay, just let me, how do you find business policy? So means this is available here in table of contents. Go to business policy. There is this folder insolvency. Go to table of contents and you'll be able to find that. Okay, answer. Okay, let's take these one first. Okay. So that is available in the business policies and notwithstanding with. So for to find the dictionary meaning, if you're looking for dictionary meaning, there is an option available for here dictionary. Maxims are available, dictionaries available. So you can check here, English dictionary, Hindi dictionary. If you're looking for a particular sentence, you can always go here. And in query, you will also be able to find the separate meaning. So for notwithstanding anything contained in the act. So individual word meaning you will be able to get from here. Okay. So this is available in module 2, sir. Sumit, sir. Let's take more business policy. We have discussed drafting material is available. Yes. So if you go to table of contents, there is a section for drafts, draft and agreements. So thousands of drafts are available, different subjects. Be able to see that from here. Okay, go up further. This we had discussed. Sumit sir, tax man is available, tribunal judgments. Tribunal courts also taxmen we cover. Okay, what are results? Ashutosh, is a very relevant question. I really forgot. So this is said results page will take you to the last open search. So which is the last one? And anytime I've opened a judgment, say I've opened a judgment in 1951. This particular act, sorry.
So the results page will also take me back. Doc is the last open document. Something is not right with the net. Search again. Okay. Doc will take me to the last open document. Okay. Advanced version has business policy. So, Gautam sir, yes, today's session will be uploaded. How to search? Okay, sir, let me, we had discussed this, but in legal search, sir, there is an option for appellant and respondent. From there, you will be able to search the party name. Okay, a lot of questions coming in. Advanced policy, party name, sir, from legal search. How can I check? Okay. How can I check whether case has been appealed? Okay. So in front of that judgment, there will be that button that I showed, SLP pending. So from there, you will be able to get check the status. So in front of any judgment, that button will be there. Can show some journey. Okay, sir. I Dipen sir, I'll take it as a feedback, and in next session we'll probably use this. Sir, international judgments are also available. Just select international. Similarly, we are selecting Supreme Court. You can always select international, and you can make your search. Niyati ma'am, you have to take a subscription from Manu Patra. So that if your college already has, your college authorities might get in touch with our team and we can arrange for something. So write to your college. So the lower courts are not available. Tribunals are available. Tribunals you can see from here. Jignesh sir, we have discussed the phrase search. So phrase search, use inverted commas for any judgment, say gender justice, and this will be a phrase search. Okay, so I have put in it as a phrase. In assisted search also, there is an option for exactly this phrase. So Manu search is for searching your keywords, text. If you have a particular section in mind, you can use the legal search. If you have a section, use legal search. If you have keywords, use Manu search. Thank you, Renoy sir. Always a pleasure. You guys are more to be given credited. You're using this time very efficiently. Okay, perfect. Okay, yes sir, last question. Okay, sir, there are different ways to search spelling mistakes, sir. It will be as it is appearing in the court. So what you can do is you can always go to legal search, because sometimes there are many parties and we put it as others. So you can use different forms for that word. So Rachit can be different, spellings can be there. So just use different forms, you will be able to use that. So that will be there, latest, it is amended latest. Okay, perfect. Thank you, sir. Thank you, all of you. If any more feedback is required, please send us a mail at contact@manupatra.com. I'll just share that mail. And another thank you for our IT team. Harish Bhai in particular, who has been working with me tirelessly to make this available to you guys. Thank you. Thank you, Manish sir. Okay.